All right, Kevin, thanks so much. In this week's edition of Positive Parenting, it's almost summertime, a couple hours to go, and of course, vacationing with your kids is on the minds of many. So to talk about that, joining us, Thom Linehan with the UNH Cooperative Extension. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
Well, the first question I have, some would say that children in long trips just don't mix.
I know, it can be very difficult to travel with children, particularly young children. And I think the first thing to think about, even though it's obvious, is to plan ahead. And if you can involve the kiddos in the planning, that can even help with that.
Interesting. And how do you plan ahead? I mean, trips that come together as a family could be an important time for, you know, establishing relationships, especially with little ones. But right. What are the best ways to do so?
Well, I think the first thing to think about is what's fair to expect of kids. And so kids of different ages have different things you can expect of them. And often with kids, when they're getting cranky and difficult on trips, it has to do with their routines, what to expect, that they always expect being disrupted. That's how they stay safe and comfortable. And when that gets disrupted, that's hard for kids. And also the anxiety of not knowing what to expect.
And what do you expect for kiddos on long trips like these?
Well, for younger kids, you're going to expect that they would be cranky, so you're going to want to try to keep their routines, bring stuff from home, stuffed animals, blankets for sleeping, food and snack and drink to keep them cool. Water's always good on a car trip because if you spill it, it doesn't get everywhere and sticky. So just planning ahead of what's going to work and what's not going to work can be helpful.
And different children need different needs on how to stay occupied, I would assume.
Right. So often when kids, especially when there's more than one kiddo in the back seat, kids can get cranky and start bickering. And so finding ways to keep them occupied is really important. And so for younger kids, some of those classic car games, you know, trying to find license plates, how many states can we find, looking for signs to find the alphabet in alphabetical order. I see an A, I see a B, all those classic things. And we probably all have some that we can remember can be really useful. And something else that's been useful is the stuff they love at home. If you can find a way to do it in the car, that can be useful too.
Perfect. Well, those are all great tips. Yeah. I know a lot of parents will definitely use them this summer. Thanks so much for joining
Thank you.
Us. Appreciate it. And we'll be right back.